As you can see, I've removed the floor boards, which I just put over here. I just wanted a new worktop there, as you probably remember, just to tidy it up a bit. And I had all the joints in the center, and a few of you OCD people out there, you want them to stagger the joints, which is the right way to do it, I know, but I just wanted to put that on there without cutting it. But I'm doing what you say, I'm staggering the joints. I'll see you in a minute. Right, well, if you saw me when I put this on, this was just a spare box of flooring that we'd had, or Gary had laying about, and I thought it would just go nicely on top of here on my existing worktop, which was starting to look a bit tired, and I thought it was going to look okay. And I didn't want to do any cutting, so I just laid it on there, filmed the video, you saw me lay it, but I had the joins right down the middle there. And quite a few of you said that, that's doing my OCD, and can you change it and do it as you should do, staggering, which I know anyway. But I've done it, I've listened to what you've said, and I'm staggering the joint. So we've got a joint there, where we'll have a joint there, we've got a joint there, we've got a joint there, and we'll have another one over here somewhere. So I'll just carry on. I've only got a couple more bits to cut now. And also someone said, oh, can I put a finishing edge on there? Well, I will, but I didn't really want to spend money doing this. But if I find an edge to go down the front there as well, I will get one. But this was only just something. When I film my videos, I literally just film here sort of thing. I was only going to do a little bit there, but I had it, I put it down, and now I'm turning out, I'm doing the job properly. Anyway, I'll see you in a minute. I'll put you on time lapse. I'm just going to finish this off. Right, okay, there we go. I've done it. Joints are now all staggered. Should keep a few of you happy. I will still have to go over some of these seams here with just a bit of wood filler, maybe some epoxy with some sawdust in, just to fill them in. But other than that, it's all right now. Happy days. Well, I had a couple more tinkering about jobs to do, but we just had a call from Gary. He wants some spares, so I'm going to have to go over there now and take him some spares. He's got 3 lawnmowers to look at, so he'll be showing them on Scrap It Man's channel. So I'll leave the link for Scrap It Man's channel below the video if you want to take a look at that. And we'll have a little sneak peek at these lawnmowers and see what he's actually bought. So let's go and have a look. Here, look, I've had to come round and supply him with parts. Look, he's using all my parts. Look, now he's hit the mower scene.
Taking over the mower scene.
He's just picked this one up. The person actually brought it round for him. It come without a plug-in and without an air filter. And we're just going to try it out for the first time. You're seeing this on my Butler's Empire channel, but this will come up on Scrap It Man's channel. So if you want to shoot over to Scrap It Man and sign up, you'll see him service this thing and hopefully make a profit on it. Sharon, what do you think of that?
Not a lot.
Hey?
Not a lot, it's a mower. Why was I thinking anything of it?
Well, I taught him all he knows, Sharon. So he's just going to whack a little plug in it, and I won't tell you what he paid for it. Let's just say he got it very, very cheap.
He paid nothing for the spark plug.
He's paid nothing for the spark plug, Sharon.
Or the filter.
So this is literally a dry run. The bloke's just dropped it off. He took his word on it that it runs. The bloke was going to bring a spark plug around. But has it got fuel in it?
Well, it's pumping.
Right. Will it start? Oh, you're having a laugh, aren't you? What's that? Oh, the cover just dropped off there. It's quiet. Yeah, these never run very well with a speed control on. Might be probably best to take that off, Gary, I would have thought. They never, it's only a cover, isn't it?
Yeah.
Has it been glued on?
Yeah, it looks like it.
Where?
It's been as white.
Oh, or is it broke off, is it? Yeah, normally you just take them off and then run them off the governor, which is the best way. No one ever, I don't know anyone who uses a speed control on these cheap type of lawnmowers with the simple Briggs & Stratton classic engines. So, okay, when you're in a business, I can understand that you want to just leave it ticking over and while you're doing other things or whatever, but for these little do-it-yourself do your own garden lawnmowers, it's not really worth having them on. So that's it. Well, it runs. You ain't done nothing to it. Happy days. The deck's solid. You can speed the speed tick over up on these. As you say, there's the cable connected down there, as you can probably see. And basically, that lever just goes, as you can see, look, backwards and forwards up there. If you take this cable off, get rid of it, and then you've got the little governor spring under there with the little arm there. You can't see it. We just put the air filter back on. And you just bend it back a little bit. That's on the smaller spring, and that increases the speed of it. It's running a bit slow at the moment, but they always tend to do that with these little controllers. Happy days. Right, what's this? You got another one?
Yeah, another one's been delivered.
So what was the story with this one?
He's put it away last summer. Went to put it out this summer, it won't start. He reckons the piston seized.
Oh, right. So you don't know what's happened to it?
Haven't got a clue.
So, right, go on then. What are you going to do then?
I'll try and see if it... I shouldn't pull it if it seized, should it?
I'll tell you what, that looks like it's vibrating a bit. Do that again. See it sort of oscillate?
Yeah.
Right, just tip it back.
I didn't notice there's a mark there. I think right. The blade's actually...
Tip it back. Take the basket off of it so we can get it back further. Hey? Oh, it's got to be done, shall. Now tip it right back and let's have a look at that blade. I think that blade might be bent, seeing that was the way that was rocking. Is that... Can you pull the... Is that plug off? Let's take that plug cap off, hold on. Right, go on it. Right, hold it back a bit further. Now just tip that, go on in. Go on, do it one more time. No, it's not rocking. No, it just looked like it was rocking a little bit to me. That's all right.
Dumb
and dumber, isn't it? What? Right, okay, put that back on. See, always worth a check. And don't forget, always take that thing off if you're gonna ever get yourself underneath a lawnmower. Right, make that back on there.
You might as well prime it while you're down there.
Might as well prime it while I'm down there. It's got fuel in it, and it's priming lovely. Three, I'll do four. I'm going to do five, sod it.
Might be stale fuel in it.
Might be. Go on it. Right, there's nothing there, is there? Right, well, I think you better have the plug out first. Yeah, you're getting fuel there. It might be stale fuel, but I mean, these should be able to start with stale fuel. They're such a basic engine, so just take that plug out, and you've got a spare one there, haven't you?
Yeah.
Have you got a spark plug tester?
It's not even done up.
It's not even done up? Yeah, there you go. What's that look like? Let's have a look. Just give it a blow, that's it. Might pull some fuel. Yeah, it just smells a bit stale, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Just put another spark plug in there. Again, he's not even looked at these yet, so you're seeing it firsthand on Butler's Empire. That's the benefit of subscribing to my Butler's Empire channel, Gary.
That's been my day off.
Just snip that up. Right, there we go. Is that one?
Yeah.
Right, give it another prime. There you go, try that. No,
get a bit of carb spray.
Just make sure we've got fuel or decent fuel. If it fires up with a carb spray, we should be all right. As I say, you never know what people have done to these things. We'll just try that. Right, so we're just going to drop a drop of a squirt in the top of the... Oh, you're going to take the plug out and do it that way?
Yeah, I'll put it
in. Can I put it in the plug hole, or you can put it in the carb by taking the air filter off? So just give that a squirt. You don't want to go too mad with that, as you know. That's it. And if this fires straight away, we know that was a fuel problem, which means the carb will come off and it will be cleaned. Sometimes it's enough to pull some fresh fuel through the carb and it might carry on running. We don't know. Or it might just start and fail. So we'll see. Nope. So there's obviously something more to this than meets the eye, and the chances are, now you know you've got decent fuel in there, you want to make sure we've got a spark, because you might have a problem with the kill switch cable, sometimes gets trapped under that, if people have had a look at it and tampered with it.
Tap on that old plug.
Right, so no spark, get this cover off, there's got to be a reason for it, and it's got probably something to do with either the coil, or the wire that comes from the coil to the back of this kill switch. So we get this cover off out of the way and we'll soon be able to find out what the problem is while we've got no spark. We know it ain't a plug because we've got a brand new plug in there. All will be revealed when we take this cover off. Right, what have we got here then? So we've got that little cover there as well to come off. We might be able to see. If we can't see nothing there, the next thing to do is to take this cover off because that wire sometimes shorts out. When that wheel rotates, sometimes it rubs through the insulation. That could stop us from having a spark. So let's have a little look under here. Oh, look at the state of all that. Like, look. Right, so just pull the lever up. If we pull this up here, we should see that open up that, which it is, so we can see that that's separating, which means that when it's open circuit, that means that your ignition circuit should be working. So that's okay. So we know the switch is okay, that's separating. So we need to take this cover off now, just to make sure that one, the coil gap is okay, and two, that that cable underneath there isn't rubbing. Here, look, he's got all the gear, look.
No idea.
Hey, I taught him, Michelle. Didn't I?
Did you?
Yeah. So depending on what Mower you've got on these classic engines, these are either 10 mil or 3/8 holding the casing on. And I think you said in your socket set, Gary, that there's no Imperial in these new Halfords professional ranges no more. This is the later version, obviously, so my one had both. Oh, I've got to do it, have I?
Well, you're there, ain't you?
Oh. Lucky I'm here, innit? Did you check the oil before we try to start it?
Yeah, I did, actually.
Yeah, I'll take your word for that, then.
I checked it when I got it out of the car.
All right, okay, I'll let you off. Right, okay, so that's that. Right, lift that cover off. Okay. Now,
there's the oil,
there's the oil, it's up to level, look. Right, sometimes these get caught and they short down to earth. So I'm not seeing any problem with that. Is there any break in that at all? No. I've very rarely had a coil go down. I've had one that's gone down. So basically, I can't see a problem with that. I can't see a problem with this. Not unless the coil's down, as I said to you, but I've only ever had one that's gone wrong. The other thing that can affect it is this cable here, where it connects there, with all the rubbish that's over there, can shorten track down to earth as well. So we give that a squirt and a wipe down. That could be stopping it from sparking as well. Yeah, get that in. Just in case it is tracking down. Right, okay then. Right, so I'm pretty happy that there's nothing wrong with that. As I say, if this now doesn't spark now, it is because there is a problem with the coil and we'll have to change the coil over. So we're going to put this cover back on now and we'll see you in a minute. Right, there you go. We've put it all back together. We've still got no spark there, so it will be an exchange coil. I've only ever had two go in my lifetime.
You just had one a minute ago.
Well, this is the second one. Oh, well, there we go. That's what he's up to. It's still going to be a good mower. It looks okay. The body works all fine on it. And you'll see these probably being repaired on Scrap It Man's channel. Time to go, Shell. I've done all what I can do today, so I'm going to go home and do my own stuff. I'll see you in a minute. Well, I'm back now, and thanks very much. I hope you've enjoyed this little tinkering about video. And if you do enjoy the channel, don't forget, click the subscribe button, ring the little notification bell, and that means you get notified every time I upload a video. Anyway, do check out my other channels as well. Butler's Empire is this channel. I've also got Retro Restore and Retro Hacks. I'll leave a link in the description below for both of them channels, and also a link to Scrap It Man's channel as well. Thanks very much. I'll see you in the next video, and until then, bye for now.